OMW, on my way to you. Good at what I do. I'm OMW, on my way to you. Good at what I do. I'm OMW. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to show you how I edit my aesthetic Y2K collages. So let's start. First things first, what apps do I use? So my main app would be the Over app. This is where I do most of my collages. And then second would be the PixArt. This is where I do the cutouts and also the stickers. It's for PNG purposes. And lastly would be the Pinterest, where I look for inspirations and backgrounds. And these apps are available for both Android and iOS users, and they are free to download. So here are my 5 favorite collages, and I'm going to show you how I made each one of them. Now let's start the tutorial. I'm going to show you how I made this first collage. So for this first collage, I call it miniature, and here are my inspirations for that particular collage. And the first thing that you need to do is you open your PixArt app, and then the next step is cut out. So select the photo that you need to remove the background, and using the cutout tool of the PixArt app, you can either use the person or outline it depending on the picture that you are trying to cut out. So after that, just brush or mark the areas that wasn't included on the cutout portion, and then you can just save it, and then you're done with the cutout portion. You save it as a PNG file, and then after saving your picture from the PixArt app, you can now go to the Over app and open a new project with a 1:1 ratio, which is a square. And then I selected this background, which is an SP Game Boy Advance, to make me look like a mini person. And then I selected the photos that I cut out. So I cut out already this 3 photos, so I just repeated the same steps kagaya nung kanina sa PixArt app. So I arranged them according to my liking. And I want to add something to the screen because I think it's kind of boring. So I added this picture. So I cropped it and then positioned it to the screen. Then after I positioned it, I used the blend mode of the application. You can see it at the bottom part of the application. So there are different categories or different functions at the bottom. So I use the overlay one to make it look like it was showing from the screen, and then I use the mask tool to clean the edges of the screen. And you can either zoom in so it would be much easier to clean the edges of the picture. And then I proceeded to remove the sharp and also unclean parts of the cutout photos that I cut out on the PixArt app. So I used again the mask tool. So after I did all of that cleaning and all of that dragging of my fingers, so then it is done. So our first tutorial miniature is done. So here is what it looks like. And I think it turned out so cute. What do you guys think? So comment down below if you guys like this photo. And now let's move on to the second one. So I entitled this one as Photobooth, and it is really popular on the IG feed. And here is my reference photo for this particular collage. So open the Over app and then make the background white. You can select 3 photos with identical background and location. So for my tip for this collage, I think it will be much better if you use a white background for your photo, so it would look like it's from a photo booth. And then I arranged them, leaving the bottom left empty. And then I added this Photo Me title. I think it's just called Photo Me. So this one you can just add whatever font you guys want, but as for me, I chose the Shipman font. I think it's
much Photobooth like font, and just I resized it and then placed it in the middle of the bottom left part. And after that, you need the following information below the photo me. So you need the price, the date, booth number, and also the customer number. So after I wrote all of those informations, I chose this font right here. So I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong. It's New Instaloom. I don't know if I'm correct, but I changed the arrangement of the text and then I place it at the bottom part of, yeah, you know where that is, you can see it. And then after that, I copied it and I added this extra detail, which is a copy number at the edge of my photo to make it look extra bit fun. I don't know, I think it's much better. And then after that, I went to my browser and searched for a QR code generator to have that little spice. And then I selected the URL and paste my IG link, and I just save it into a PNG file. And I went to the over app again and added the QR code photo to add a little more spice to the photo. I searched for a barcode generator again. So I added a barcode. It's not the same as yung kanina. So yung kanina is a QR code, now is a barcode. If you just want to be as extra as me, you can do the same, or you may skip it. You may skip this step. So after saving the barcode, I placed it on the upper left corner to make it look like it was from the price of the photo booth. It's a barcode, you know. And after saving the picture, I went to the Adobe. I don't know, so Adobe Sketchbook. So it's an app, so I will add the scribbles or the doodles there. So I selected the marker as my pen. You can be as creative or funny, it depends on what you want. So I drew this horns or a devil-like, this details outline. And then after you draw on your photo booth picture, you can just save it. And then lastly, I went to the Adobe Lightroom to adjust the sharpness and also the texture of the photo to make it look like it was scanned, or you printed it from the photo booth and then you scanned it to your printer, if you get what I mean. And our second tutorial is done. So this is what the photo booth looks like. I think it's so cute. And now let's move on to the third collage. And here I always do this, and I named it as 2000s magazine collage. And the first thing that you need to do is you go to the over app, create a new project with a 1:1 ratio, which is a square, and select your desired photos that you want to use. Position it to where you think all the details of the outfits is being showed. So sometimes I skip the PixArt part to cut out my photos, and I just go directly to the over app. Use the mask tool to remove the background of the photo. Zoom in so it would be much easier to remove the background. So after you remove the background, I added this letters to represent each part of the outfit, if you get what I mean. So I placed it at the left side, the letter A. So I think I added four letters, which is A, B, C, D, to represent the top, the jacket that I use, the shorts, and also the pants. So I positioned the letters kung saan talaga naka-place yung outfit para alam nila yung nire-represent ng each letters. So, after adding that, I added this detail. So, what Rachel is wearing. So, I represented each letter with a short sentence. So, here is what it looks like. Isn't it super easy to do? So, for our first collage, I entitled it as Giant World. So, here are some of the inspirations I saw from the Pinterest app. So, for this one, I looked for a background first using the Pinterest app. So, I looked for a desert sand background. You must consider the following when choosing your background. So, one is the angle of your photo, then the color, temperature, lighting, and also the quality of your background. For this particular collage, you can either plan out the background first before doing your photo shoot, or do your photo and look for the perfect background. So the first thing that you need to do is you open your Over app and you select the background that you chose from the Pinterest app and positioned it. And then I added the photos that are already a PNG file, so I cut out it already. So for this first picture, I cropped it and made it seem like I was in the background of the desert, if you get what I mean. So as you can see here, my picture is very dark, so I played with the adjustment settings. So I added exposure and lowered the contrast and sharpened the image. So after that, I used the mask tool to remove the excess part of the picture. But as you can see, I cannot see the desert part, so I used the blend mode, multiply, and then proceeded with the erasing or the mask tool again to remove the excess part of the photo. I think this is much easier to remove because you can see the desert part and it is divided, so it would be much easier to erase. And then after that, I chose another two photos. So as for this two photos, I did the same thing. I adjusted it, removed the excess part, and then if you're done with your mask thingy, you can just save it. And then after saving it, I went to the PixArt app and selected the photo, and then I added this moon sticker. So I searched for the sticker part or sticker option there at the PixArt, and then search for moon. Then I positioned the moon at the upper right part of the photo and played around with the brightness so it would look nice, or it is much better, I think. So after that, you save it, and then your fort or the giant world is done. I think this one is my favorite. So down to my last tutorial, and this is really the popular one, and it's a cyber Y2K collage. And here are my inspirations again for this photo. For this one, I searched over Pinterest app Y2K background, and I just scrolled there and look for the most suitable background for the photos I'm going to use. So after years of searching to the Pinterest app, I chose this photo and I adjusted it. So I placed it as my background and then selected the photos that I'm going to use. So I selected this particular picture or the outfit that I'm going to post. So I positioned it, started duplicating it into three. So you can either add other poses, but I chose not to make it look neat. So I arranged them overlapping with each other. So then I searched a folded paper texture on the Pinterest app, and I just looked there, and there are a lot of choices, but I chose this one instead. So I just save it and went to the Over app again, place this photo or this texture, and using the blend mode, I chose the screen to make my photo look like a folded paper, if you get what I mean. So that is basically it. So that is super easy. So here is what it looks like, and I think it's so cute. So sad to say, that is the last tutorial that I'm going to show you. So I think they are really easy and they are really popular. So if you have a boring type of picture and you want to play around with your background, you can do each one of those if you want. So I hope I explained it very clear, and I hope you understood it, and make sure to follow those steps and you can create a lot of collages. And don't forget to tag me once you upload your photos on your IG, and I would always make a lot of these collages in the future. So make sure you follow me on my IG also. So comment down below what other tutorials you guys want to see on my channel. And a friendly reminder for you guys, be as creative as you can. So go out your comfort zone if you want to play around with your background, or you want something entertaining, or you want to catch the eyes of your followers. You can do this collages para mas maraming mapukaw sa iyong mga feed. I think it's another extra oomph to your feed para mas maganda siyang tingnan. I think it's so cute that if you want to add this a little fun collages to your Instagram account. So yeah, that is all of my collage tutorials. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know if you guys want more of this tutorials. So thank you for watching. I hope I would see you on my next video. Bye.